Lowell, Chief Investment Officer, Advisor Investments, AUM, Assets Under Management, $5.5 billion with a B at last count, live on the line out of Boston, Massachusetts. Jim, always good to talk to you, and thank you for your time. So you think, I know, you know, an investor would be better off being in cash and also in bonds, which sounds pretty bearish. And you also think the threat of a correction has risen. What's gotten us here?
Well, first of all, we take a very balanced approach. So I do think that now is a good time for any investor who's enjoyed 10 years of market gains on the growth side of the ledger to sit down, really, really focus on whether or not their objectives, their income needs, their risk tolerance is closely and correctly correlated to what may or may not transpire. We know that we're in the late stages of a very long and beneficial bull market here. Good economic growth continues, fundamentals, earnings, low interest rates, economic data continues to suggest that we may have still a growth road ahead of us. Nevertheless, I think the threat of some sort of pullback has clearly risen. If the fundamentals aren't revealing why, certainly the daily headlines and the behavioral aspect of those headlines driving people to make decisions based on fear rather than fundamentals, I think has risen, and the threat of correction correlated to headlines has risen alongside it.
So, Jim, just to paraphrase what you've just said, you know, if you've made money in this market, be happy with what you have and get out while you can.
Well, I wouldn't say get out while you can, but I would say it is definitely a perfect moment to take stock of the gains that you've been able to enjoy and think through very carefully and considerably where you may or may not be able to de-risk some of that portfolio. The bond market's not a piece of cake. In fact, if you look at the averages year-to-date, Bloomberg Barclays aggregate bond is basically down a little bit. NASDAQ's still up almost 10% when you include dividends. So the gap between stocks and bonds remains relatively large. And when you look at relative values, it's still hard to knock good dividend growth paying stocks that are yielding about as much as the 10-year Treasury with some good defensive capital appreciation built into them. So I wouldn't run for the exits, but I would definitely, as they tell you when you sit down to watch a movie, be mindful of where the exits are.
Jim, talk to us about the rattlesnake.
I've been trying to figure out a way to talk to people about just how poisonous and toxic the headline environment has become. We really are hearing a lot of fear and outright anger in terms of policies and proposed countermeasures to the policymakers here on this side of the fence. So a story that caught my eye was about a man who cut off a rattlesnake head while working in the yard with his wife. And when he went to remove the snake's body, the decapitated head struck him, and the full amount of that snake's toxin nearly killed him. So the moral of that story is just because you think you're going to be able to cut the head off of whatever poisonous thing it is that you don't like doesn't mean you've eliminated the risk. And I think in particular for investors who are being driven by headlines, not fundamentals, it's very important to take heed that this is not a time where you want to follow herd mentality. You really want to take a measured, deliberate, careful approach to everything you own and everything you might want to own.
Okay, some really good advice, I think, there, Jim. Appreciate your time. Thank you so much for joining us here on the program today. Well, still to